Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is The Face Sociologist, and welcome back to Doki Doki Literature Club. In this video, that is, this time we're taking a look at the Understanding Part 1 side story. We're just going to go ahead and start it. So let's see what's going on. The club meeting is suddenly interrupted by the sound of the door, causing Monica and Sayori to turn their heads. The door opens halfway, then stops. A face peeks inside, a face that seems familiar. Yeah, that's Yuri. Sayori's eyes wide, recognizing the girl. She's very conspicuously mouths to Monica. It's her, it's the girl. It's true, the girl standing there in the doorway is none other than the girl Sayori had come across reading alone in the classroom. Thanks to Monica leaving the flyer on her desk, it seems she's found her way to the club. Are you here for the literature club by any chance? Am I in the wrong place? No, you're not. This is the literature club. Please come inside. The girl fully steps into the door but continues standing against the wall, avoiding eye contact. Sayori continues to fail, containing her excitement. It's happening, oh my gosh. Thank you so much for coming. Sorry, it's a little empty. I'm Monica and this is Sayori, and we run the literature club. Even though you just asked so far, but what's your name, by the way? I'd like to join your club already. Wait, really? Are you sure? I mean, I should be good enough. Hi, everyone is welcome here. You don't have to be good enough. Do you want to have a seat? We'd love to get to know you. The girl nods, sliding over to nearby desk and gently sitting down. So what's your name? Yuri. I'm Sayori and this is Monica. Sayori, I already... Nice to meet you. Do you like fantasy? Like books? Yuri looks at Monica. Fantasy is cool. Yes, have you heard of Annabelle Dupont? I can't say I have. Oh, well, she's my favorite author. I'm on her fifth book and it's just... Yuri grins and presses her knuckles against her cheeks in joy. You can borrow my books, I wouldn't mind. You're really in for an incredible experience. Monica stammers, caught completely off guard by Yuri taking control of the conversation. She glances sideways at Sayori, silently asking for help. I'd love to, it sounds like you're really into them, so they must be great. I am so happy I found this club. Oh, I'm so stupid, I left all my other books in my locker, should have brought them. Yuri quickly stands up. I'll be right back, I'll go get them for you. You probably only need to bring one for now. Sayori nervously says that, noting to herself the considerable heftiness of the book that Yuri set down on her desk. True, okay, I'll go get the first one then. Yuri exits the club room in a flash, leaving Monica and Sayori silently exchanging glances. Oh my god, I wasn't prepared for this. How do I handle someone so intense? I have like no experience with fantasy except maybe stuff that I read when I was a kid, but that's probably like a joke compared to what she's into. I'm sure it'll be fine. In fact, I think it's neat that we have different people who are into different kinds of literature. It'll be fun to learn from each other. Yeah, I mean, I don't disagree, but what if this is her only interest? Doesn't kind of seem like that. Monica, don't you think you should be more optimistic? We have a new club member. There shouldn't be room for anything but being happy. I'm excited to get to know her more, aren't you? Yeah, I guess you're right. Sorry for being so hasty, I just got really anxious all of a sudden. It's because you're afraid of not being able to take the lead. What the heck? It's kind of scary how you can point things out like that, Sayori. I just like learning what makes people happy or sad. Yeah, hey, you know what? It'd probably be great at helping you to feel comfortable here. Maybe you could take a break for helping me with the administrative stuff and just focus on spending time with her. Yeah, that's exactly what I want to do besides. Sayori lowers her voice. Probably gonna need all the time I can get. She taps her fingers against the dauntly chunky book Yuri left sitting on the desk. Right afterwards, the door opens to reveal Yuri's return. I'm back. Her breath is slightly heavy, which combined with her short time gone indicates she may have run at least far to the way. She makes her way back over to Sayori, sets the book down on her desk. Just as Sayori feared, the book Yuri brought for her is just about equal in size to the one already on Yuri's desk. Well, there are probably a few things you should know before getting started on it. There are some things that are more explained in other books that take place in the same universe. So going over those would be good to keep you from getting confused at the start. Sayori nervously interjects. Well, I was thinking that maybe today we could just get to know each other a little bit more. You know, I think like if we're gonna be reading together, then I would like that. From across the room, Monica smiles and nods to Sayori while Yuri isn't looking. Oh, okay. Yuri sits down and looks at her book, then glances around the room, showing no indication that she has anything more to add. So, what made you decide you wanted to join the club? Well, I like reading, so I was immediately interested. I had no idea that someone was starting a literature club, but that's my fault since I haven't been paying attention to any of the club recruitment advertisements. I only found out because Yuri glanced over at Monica. Monica came into my classroom and put a flyer on my desk. Suddenly Yuri's face darkens and she shakes her head at herself. I was so stupid, I got too nervous, I couldn't even look up, so she just walked out. It took me several days just to come here because I was afraid of Monica. Told everyone how inconsiderate I was, but I said it was probably irrational. Wait, no, that was totally my fault. I felt so bad about interrupting you that I just like walked out. I was actually really hoping that you would come by. Yuri exhales in relief. I always seem to interpret things as the worst possible scenario. Well, I was really nervous to come here for some other reasons too, such as there being too many people. Not that I mind that much, but I have a really hard time having to meet a large number of new people at once. So it's actually amazing that it's just the two of you. I definitely came at the right time. Ah, that makes me happy. I'm proud of you for working up the courage to come. Yuri smiles warmly to herself. I never really had the privilege of sharing my interests with others before. It's so hard to find others who are into the same things I am, except online. So I thought the literature club would provide a chance for me to do that. What kind of other things are you into? Like genres? I don't know, just anything, even if it's not literature. Oh, just things you would think are dumb. Sayori pauses, a look of concern on her face. How about I tell you about something I'm into, then you can tell me about something you're into. I suppose that would be okay. Okay, well, I'm pretty into like crafty things, like making cute little collages or decorating things like cards or jewelry boxes. My room is always cluttered with random stuff because I keep buying things to make gifts for my friends, but then I put it off till the last minute, hehehe. So yeah, that's something kind of silly that I'm into. You sound quite creative. Not that much, it's just that you'd be surprised by how much you can do with scissors and glue and stuff. So I have to share something that I'm into now, right? Well, I guess I'm into nature. I love nature. Monica, I'm going to start a nature club. No, you're not. You're stuck here with me now. I am not. Oh, yeah? Well, I hereby appoint you vice president of the literature club. There, now you're stuck with me. Hey, don't give me responsibilities. Oh, I'm sorry, Yuri. I interrupted you. Go ahead. It's fine. Yuri pauses, feeling awkward after having gotten cut off. I like going out into the woods or to the park, just places you can walk or sit and not have any people around. It's peaceful. Just nice to kind of remove myself from everything that matters and let my racing mind operate autonomously for a while. When do you like to do that? It just depends on my mood. After school, on the weekends, whenever I feel like I need it. Well, I feel like I've never had time to do something like that. I find that we have a lot more time than we think we do if you don't let it slip through your fingers. The three continued their conversation, led primarily by Sayori, but with Monica chiming in every now and then as well. Monica had intended to leave it to Sayori and focus on her own work, but she found it difficult not to join in. Before they knew it, the end of the day was upon them once more. Oh, it looks like we should be wrapping up for today. So are you two going to be starting on that book at the next club meeting? That's the plan. I'm so excited. Sayori beams, Yuri collects her things. Once packed, Yuri wordlessly waves to Sayori and Monica with a gently smile. Bye. As Yuri exits, Sayori enthusiastically returns her farewell. Once again, Sayori and Monica are left in the club room. Sayori, you are a lifesaver. Hey, I didn't do anything, I just talked. Still, besides, it really lifted my mood. It feels really nice when I can put my energy towards other people like that. She was really excited to be included, you know? It made me happy. Well, there's no doubt in mind that she'll have a great time here with you engaging her. How are you feeling about starting the book with her next meeting? I'm kind of scared, but I think she'll be happy as long as I'm trying my best. I think you'll do great. After the surprise of a new club member, it seems like everyone has their spirits lifted. Something new to look forward to. Okay, interesting. Another school day ends. Swallowing her anxiety, Yuri makes her way to the club room, expecting to be the last one to arrive. As she opens the door, she's surprised to find only Sayori in the club room. It's club time again. Monica went to the computer lab, so just us today. Is that okay? Yuri silently nods, unable to make eye contact. I'm sorry about yesterday. Huh? Sorry, Thistle. Oh boy. Sayori tilts her head, unsure of exactly what Yuri is talking about. Well, I mean, the way I got overly excited to share my books and how you had to stop me so we could talk first. It was so inconsiderate of me. I got too excited and forgot to think about everyone else in the club, so... Yuri didn't do anything wrong. But it was good how excited you were. Well, still, I think I changed my mind about the book. We don't have to read it. Okay, yeah, why? Because I know that you were just humoring me anyway. In retrospect, it's rather obvious that nobody was truly interested. Whew. But if you like it so much, then it must be worth sharing. I already decided I'll join the club, so you don't have to try so hard to entice me. That's not what I was doing. A moment of uncomfortable silence stretches between the two of them. Well, the thing is, we don't even have any club activities yet. I mean, Monica and I have just been working on recruitment stuff mostly. So it just sounds like something fun that we could do together, reading your books. You know, like as a club activity, that will be okay, right? Why am I being so resistant to this anyway? It's exactly what I wanted in the first place. And you're being so nice about it. I really don't know what's wrong with me. I'm sorry for being like this. You don't have to apologize, just tell me if there's anything I can do to help you feel more comfortable here. Okay, much better. Sayori pulls the desk up against Yuri's and sits next to her. The book in question is already on Yuri's desk. Peering over, Sayori reads the cover of the book. Dusk Bell, part 1 of the Everlast Saga. It's Dusk Bell by Annabelle. Sorry, I'm ready now. Alright, I should probably get some paper. Yuri grabs a spiral notebook of hers and tears out a few sheets of paper. Wait, how come you need paper? Oh, it's useful to draw things out sometimes, like maps, timelines, family trees, or just for taking notes. Notes? I mean, yes, that's an effective strategy, exactly. I'm sure it would especially be helpful for someone new to the genre. Sorry, joke flew completely over Yuri's heads, but thinking about it, she decided it's probably for the best that it did. Well, I'm not used to having company through this, but I'll try to help make it as accessible as possible. I trust you, you're like super smart. Oh, please. Yuri tries to dismiss the compliment, but she can't hide her smile and light blush. You can generalize intelligence, I'm only smart in things I have a lot of experience with. Contrarily, I'm awful at anything involving real people. That should be evident enough from the 2 days I spent here so far. So in my eyes, it's everyone else who comes off as smart, especially you. No. That I have to show that against Yuri's. You're such a sweetheart when you're not being shy. Anyway, would you like to get started? Okay. After the minor diversion between them, the two get back on track with their planned club activity. Yuri begins to guide Sayori for the basics on the fantasy world her story takes place in, the more of it she details, the races, factions, history, elements of magic. The more questions Sayori seems to have, but despite Sayori's expectations, Yuri eloquently guides her through it in a way that is such that it's fun to follow along. Well, it's evident that the world-building aspect of the story, not just the story itself, is one that Yuri finds her passion leaning towards. How do people come up with this stuff? It's like the exact opposite of the kind of writing that I do. What kind of writing? Oh, I like poetry and stuff like that. The things I write are like just putting down the feelings that come into my head, you know? But this is like there must be so much planning and hard work. Ah, you're into poetry. I think there's an appendix that includes some of the kingdom's written works, like poetry and folk songs. No way. Yuri giggles, feeling Sayori's heart with happiness when she realizes the first time she's heard Yuri laugh. It means Yuri must be having fun. Anyway, I think we can get started reading now if you're ready. Okay, but I can't read very fast. Oh, that's fine. I'm very patient. Patience is something I pride myself in. I see. So just Yuri's patient into her notes. Hey, that's for the book. I'm just kidding. But I'm kind of glad you're patient because I need that sometimes. A lot of times. Sayori flips through the first few pages of the book, getting past the table of contents. Okay, chapter 1. The room becomes silent as the two of them begin to read. But the silence only lasts for a moment before Sayori speaks up again. What does vindicated mean? Oh, well, in this context, it essentially means that he was proven innocent. It's okay to ask questions, right? Of course. Sari turns the page. Are these footnotes? Mm-hmm. A lot of the dialogue has cultural references that require explanation to be understood. The two continue reading. Yuri's relaxed expression remains unchanged. Meanwhile, Sari's expression grows tense as she tries to make her way through the dense text. Up until now, their expression had been reversed, with Sari easily navigating social situations and Yuri struggling them. But the tables have turned. Wait, are they talking about the past right now or the present? Where? Right here, they're talking about the past. These paragraphs are describing a flashback that Barnas is having. But they didn't tell me that. It's implied from the context. Sari rubs her temples. The two of them continue with Sari asking fewer questions. She begins to understand the value in the notes as she finds herself referring to them somewhat often, and even adding to them, but her reduction in question comes not from her getting used to the reading, but rather from her fearing that she'll come across as stupid. Last, Sari reaches the end of the chapter. I think we can stop here for now. Okay. So he takes a deep breath and closes what little of the book she's gotten through so far. So, what are your thoughts up to this point? Sari tries to find words. Am I doing well so far? I'm not sure I understand. Well, I don't know. When it takes me so long to read and understand things, it makes me feel really dumb. But I really like how into it you get. It makes me want to keep going and to keep doing my best so I can see it the way that you do. The relaxation in Yuri's expression fades. I see. Yuri quietly gathers her things. We can continue tomorrow, right? Yuri pauses and shakes her head. We can do something else tomorrow. But I'm sorry. Wait, sorry for what? I don't understand. I'm sorry. I don't want to do this anymore, that's all. I'm sorry that I made you. Yuri leaves. You weren't making me. Sari's left alone with her words. How did this happen to me? We were having fun just a second ago. It's my fault. I said something stupid and hurt her. I should have just told her that I enjoyed it. Monica trusted me with this. It's the only thing I'm good at. It still messed it up. What if she doesn't want to come back? Johnny Glissari stares blankly at her desk, spread with notes. The book sits next to them. Right, if she wasn't coming back, then she wouldn't have left the book here, right? Unless she just forgot to take it with her. This is horrible. Was it really because she thought I wasn't enjoying our time together? Or maybe she wasn't enjoying our time together because I'm not good enough? I probably let her down so much by having trouble following along. Yeah, I'm sure if I was smarter, she would have be having so much more fun. I need to do better for her. That's it for part one. No new mail. We did get a new picture. Yeah, there we go. Okay. And that unlocks understanding part 2.